So hi everybody, I think it's time to start the next presentation. First of all, thanks for joining us today. My name is Peter Rees. I am the head of HBO GO tactical deployment in Europe. And you may know HBO, the brand HBO, and also HBO GO, but you may don't know what we really do in Europe and what HBO really does in Europe. So first of all, a few information about HBO presence in Europe. HBO arrived to Europe, mainly in the Central European region, more than 20 years ago. So it's not a new initiative, it's a well-known brand and business here in Europe. At the beginning, HBO was present with the traditional linear TV channels, SD channels, and later on the HD channels. And as an early adopter, we just introduced the SVOD with our affiliate partners on the very early times. We have presence in Europe in 15 countries. The biggest market is Poland, Romania, the Adriatic region, Czech Republic, Slovakia, and the newest family member is the Netherlands. We just launched our joint venture here with Zigo. Our headquarters in Budapest. So we just organized the business and all the technical development and operation from Budapest, Hungary. We have developed our HBO GO platform in Budapest. So we use the same name and the same brand than HBO in the US. But from technical point of view and from operational point of view, it's a total different development and a total different solution. You may have heard about HBO Nordic. As you see, HBO Nordic is a separate from us, so they are a different business, part of the big HBO family, but independent from HBO Europe. So today we are here to show you a little bit our operation in Europe, how we developed HBO GO platform, what is the European HBO GO platform at all, and we would like to share some experience a little bit from technical point of view, but also from business and broadcaster point of view, what is the lesson, what we learned in the last 2 years. So why HBO GO? Why HBO GO is important for HBO, and in more generic, why a TV Everywhere project is important for a TV provider, and not just for a TV providers, for broadcasters, telecom companies. So TV Everywhere is important for us and for everybody. HBO as an early enabler of the premium services, from our point of view, it was a very logical step to move to the TV Everywhere universe. But as you may see during the presentation, if you do our work well, this HBO GO is a little more and a little different than a logical step in the evolution, and a little more and a little more complicated than simple VOD over the internet. So if you start a journey or a development like HBO GO, first of all, you need a strong reason. Our reason is pretty simple. We believe our industry, the whole broadcast industry, faces a tsunami. We don't know when this tsunami will hit us, and we don't know how big this tsunami will be. So we don't know it really will happen, but currently we see a high chance it will happen. And because nobody knows what will happen after this tsunami, when the traditional broadcast business, the traditional rules just broken, we just want to be ready. So we see what we can do, just build a big boat. We don't know if this boat is big enough against the tsunami or not, but our current job is just build the biggest and the best boat what we can build and use it if the tsunami is coming. As you know, in Game of Thrones, winter is coming and we just want to be ready. That's simple our reason. If you have a reason, it's nice and fine, but nobody will subscribe for your service and nobody care about your brand because your only reason is you want to survive and you want to be on the market. So if you have a boat, if you have a product like HBO GO, you need to know and you need to find a way to use it on the sunny days. And it's really a challenge. Time to time we need to remember ourselves. HBO GO is just to support our business, not to destroy our business, as we say. So HBO GO for us is just a new tool to support the HBO generic vision and generic mission. So it's not a separated something, it's part of the whole HBO DNA. We can talk about a lot about visions, missions, etc., but I think the best way if I show you a short video which can illustrate what we really believe about HBO and HBO GO.
Stories. There was a time when they really mattered. Like opening up a door into another world. Wherever. Whenever. Then.
Here to tell you stories, and we believe we can tell the stories the best. That's HBO. And HBO GO is just a new tool to help us to tell more stories anytime, anywhere. HBO GO also part, as I mentioned, is part of our brand, so has the same promise, the quality entertainment. It's part of our package, so available with the traditional linear channels, and also part of the partnership what we have with our strategic partners just to help us to deliver an extra value and a successful business not just for HBO but also for our partners. So that's HBO is and that's what HBO GO is. It's a new tool to tell the stories on the new popular platforms and also a technical solution us to provide more exclusive content to our viewers. So today we are here to tell you a story, so that's about HBO in high level. Today we are here to tell you a story about our last 2 years. This is a true story, it's about a lot of painful decisions, hard times, about the video formats, DRMs, license issues, as you see later. We are here to tell this story, we are happy to share our experiences with you, and it may help you just to write your story in the future. If you ask the customers what they really want, and that's a famous quote from Henry Ford, they will say they want faster horse. So customer want faster horse. And it's very important to keep in mind. So what does it really tell us? If you start a journey like what we did with HBO GO 3 years ago, it's nobody will tell you what to do and how to do. Maybe you can help, you can find some help from technical point of view. There are some companies, white papers, more and more best practices and information. But if you want to deliver something, a quality service over the internet, video on demand service as we are, you are your own. So you need to figure out what to do. This sentence doesn't mean you don't need to listen to your customers. You need to listen what they really use, what they really like, what they really do. But if you just ask a direct questions, what they want, what you want, they will say, okay, I want a faster horse. So it's a very complicated and a painful lesson what we learned. We talk a lot about HBO GO or platform in generic. Mm-hmm. So I think it's the time to show you what we really did, what we really do, and what HBO GO is in Europe. This is a short movie, a concept video, if you like to call it, about the next HBO GO interface and functionality, what we will release in this September. So you are the one of the few lucky ones who see it before the official premiere.
Welcome to HBO GO. It's one click on your computer or your TV. One touch on your phone or your tablet. And an exclusive library of movies and series opens up, no matter where you are. If you are an HBO subscriber, all you need to do is register. Go to the hbogo.eu website, choose your cable provider, set up a password, and you're ready to go. Once you're in, the entire HBO universe is at your fingertips. Launch into a show immediately.
The next time Samoan speaks, kill him.
Select your language and subtitle.
Érzed a különbséget?
Stop. Rewind. Fast forward, switch to any of your devices. Or leave and continue later at the exact same place within the show. HBO GO keeps track without you having to do anything. Even with over 1400 hours of content, it's still easy to navigate on HBO GO. There are several ways to find exactly what you're looking for, whether you're just browsing or looking for something specific. Trailers, pictures, and info will all help you find what you want, whether it's a classic HBO show or one of the newest episodes. Share your experience immediately. It only takes one click to contact your friends or others watching the same show, and let them know how you rate and what you think of the program. HBO GO is there for you to shape and match exactly to your habits. Rearrange the entire HBO GO interface and change it any way you want. While browsing, One Touch will add a movie to your watch list, making your own selection easy to return to anytime, anywhere. The History panel will show you exactly where you left off with a certain movie or series. And the Parental Control button keeps HBO GO safe, even with your kids playing around with your tablet. Keep your favorites close to you, even when you travel off the map. With HBO GO's handy download option, you don't need to be online anymore to enjoy them. Left your device home? Not a problem. Use the remote download function to get everything ready by the time you return. Get it, play it, find it, share it, shape it, pack it. The stories you love just got a whole lot closer to you. HBO GO. It's HBO anywhere.
So that's what makes us busy today. I hope you enjoy it. So after the product, I think it's time to talk about a little bit in the technical background. So let me introduce Peter Dikazi, the main architect of our platform. And he will share you some technical details, and I'm sure he has some comment and feedback about the previous presentation about the encoding formats and the challenge on the player side.
Thank you very much. Let's see what is in the background. So first of all, let's just walking around about the broadcast content workflow. The first point is the content encoding, and the previous presentation tell us a lot of information about the formats, about codec, and so on. But the main question, if you have a content and relatively want to just put to the internet, so what is the key questions? First, delivery format. On demand, I want to do a live stream, I want to make a download. If I have a content, this is a multi-track audio, single-track audio, I have a multi-channel double surround, or I have subtitles or multiple subtitles. Based on this, we need to choose a format. A format or a container which is responsible for the whole content. Another thing is the codec. The codec is important from the content preparation case and the devices case, because as you see in the previous presentation, not all type of devices support all type of codecs. What about the resolution and the bandwidth? Because, the encoder tools can able to prepare HD or maybe 4K streams, but the content license is limiting these. So sometimes if you can put HD quality content on a broadcast, in the OTT business or TV everywhere case, you are not able to do maximum SD format. And the second thing is the bandwidth. What is the best bandwidth for this? We need to also calculating. Another very important question is how many format we choose support. If I select the best one and only one, it's very good, because from a storage perspective, we will have only one. From supporting perspective, we will have only one. But this is not just encoding. We need to talk about the metadata. How to integrate your current asset management system with a new OTT business or TV-aware business line. The second main thing is the distribution. CDNs. What type of CDN available on our territory? We have a public CDNs like Akamai, Limelight, Level 3, or we have a very strange territory where the public CDNs is not there, and we need to set up a private CDN. From CDN point of view, we also need to talking about the formats. If I select one format, maybe this will support the CDN. Let's say MPEG-Dash. MPEG-Dash is maybe not supported everywhere right now. If I have a downloading format, this will be supported by the CDN. If not, maybe we need to set up a smaller but private CDN. If you want to cover a kind of territory, in the HBO case, it's more than 10 countries. Sometimes the licensing is protect the content in some territories. So if I want to release something, it's not available in different countries right now. And in this case, we need to use a geographical protection. Plus, when we're talking about premium content, the premium content need to protect somehow, need to protect with DRM. And when we're talking about DRM, the native players, what you hear in the previous presentation, you need to forget it. Because the DRM is another part. And if you want to protect something with the DRM, you need to use plugins or other techniques to play back the protected content. And the third thing is our main product, the application. What we need to consider when we choosing a format or choosing codecs? The device. What type of codecs available on the device and what type of DRM available on these? And of course, if I selected the right codecs, the right player, the right secure player, the right DRM solution, we need to think about how can we measure the quality. We need to check the quality of the service. I'm talking about the buffers, talking about the startup time, talking about the streaming quality. These are also need from the content workflow perspective. Let's see what is the designing principles. The first of all, from infrastructure point. The infrastructure point, we believe the modular system. The modular system means we can build everything from modules. We can call it as building blocks. What does that mean in the real world? Let's say we have a servers and we try to use build up a kind of private CDN or managing infrastructure. We're using one type of servers and we try to build this type of unique server from everything. Why is it important? Let's say I set up an origin server or a management server, but some reason I need to disassembly and create a new one. If I'm using unique servers, I can take it and build in another infrastructure without any changes. Another very important thing is the blocks. What means the blocks? If I'm talking about again, origin server. Origin server may be a storage, a server, more servers, more storages, switches, routers, everything. We are thinking this is a pack. It's called origin server infrastructure. This will be also important from management perspective too. We have an infrastructure, this can be also a private CDN or a public CDN. These are also blocks from our perspective, but how can we organize it? You want to put everything in a data center and build a big data farm, or you want to put in different data center making telling about the failover solution, or you can take this server and spread out your territory. Why is it important? Because from costing perspective, the domestic bandwidth is sometimes much cheaper like the international. So if I'm building a big data center in one place and need to take care of the international bandwidth. This is a big higher price if you put the server to the local data center, and sometimes the connection will be much faster. But we mix these two things, mix the global and mix the distribution things. We can spread out the servers, but we can keep the global thinking. It means we have a global server, which is managing the distributed servers. Typically, like the public CDN case, we have origin server and we have edge servers around the territory, but this is not just in a private CDN case. We apply the same formula in a management or case too. Designing principle from software perspective. Ecosystem. The ecosystem is a kind of software which is running top of this type of architecture and manage the content licensing, the content distribution, the services, the reports, and every other things. Here we also building a modular systems. So for example, if we put a new server to the system, we just create a new groups, create the servers, put in a new groups, and automatically start up to working. So it means it's very quickly can deploy new servers, new application, new providers into the system. The ecosystem has a lot of functionality and we can call unified system management. But I like to highlight one very, very important thing. It's called affiliate integration. As Peter mentioned, this is a part of the HBO brand. What does it mean exactly? HBO has a content, HBO has a service, but the customer is not belongs to the HBO. So the affiliate partners like the telco providers or operator providers has the HBO subscribers. In this case, the HBO GO is kind of gateway between the content and between the operators. And in this case, need to create an integration with the CRM systems. From registration point, this is also very important. This is not a typical registration. It's not like a username and password like a social site case. It's three steps. One is the username and password, of course. The second is we need to get a green light from the operator provider telco system. The user has a subscription or not. And the third thing, what the content licensing is also defining, how many devices can use one subscriber, how many device changes in 1 month, and how many concurrent stream uses. So these are also part of the ecosystem. It means if I want to start three streams in three different devices because the system allows it, the third one will be kill another one because this is part of the licensing. Applications. Application is when we creating a premium application, it's need to fit with the premium UI, premium user experience. What does it mean from our perspective when we develop something? It needs a very smooth, very responsible UI, need a very fast startup, and need a seamless playback. I like to mention again, it's very important to get information back from the players about the quality. If we take the application development and put into a formula, and this formula will include a lot of unknown variables. If I like to select two things, two very dangerous things, the one is the network. This is also mentioned in the old presentation, typically like the 3G, the LTE networks. And the second thing is the devices. When we're talking about DRM protected content, in this case, we have not using the native players. We have to buy a kind of library which is responsible for the playback. This library is using, for example, hardware acceleration, using other secure techniques. And sometimes the Android manufacturer from China is creating relatively cheap devices. Customer buy, download the application from the market, try to play it. But sometimes this is not fit with our requirements. What does it mean from support perspective? We don't know what type of devices will be available on the market. In this case, we need to integrate some kind of diagnostic tool to the application, which is provide us a proactive support. We want to see a trends, we want to see the patterns, we want to see everything behind that, because when the customer will call the operator, so I have a problem with the application, we should know the exact answer immediately. So let's summarize what is important if you somebody want to create a TV everywhere or OTT application from technical point of view. One thing is, if you want to describe the OTT with few words, we have a content we want to put into the internet. It's simple. One side is a broadcast things where we need to prepare the content somehow. This is part of our traditional business. And this type of business typically takes half of year or a complete year. From another hand, this is an internet man. This is just only 1 or 2 days to develop something. So the OTT development is somewhere middle of these two parts. It's a half year development and 1 day development. It's very important to understand it. The second is the premium UI, as I mentioned again. In this case, we need to take care about the seamless playback, the buffer-free, relatively zero startup time, and very, very responsive UI. It's not an easy question, because if somebody want to calculate how should we develop, and many developers, yeah, we can create a kind of website, integrate into the player, and we will solve everything. No. In the premium application development case, we need to use a native application support. It means need to write the code in Java, Objective-C, and in a civilized case, a C#. So we have a very deep level of support. It's important. This type of project is it's a new thing in a market. What does it mean? It means is we have no relatively good method how to do something. It means is something need to build the project from scratch. We have no enough information, just we have a deadline and we need to release something. This is also a kind of challenges. Cooperation. Of course we can put some content which is available in our library, but sometimes this content coming from a marketing side, coming from the creative services, coming from the online market, online media case, it means we have need to cooperate with different departments in one country. Strategic partnership is also important, because if you buy a component, like a secure player in an application, the vendor is need to understand what we want to do, why we want to do, and why we want to use this type of technology. Because, for example, we like to reduce the storage space in the CDN. We don't want to create, for example, 7 different formats what the platform is supported. And sometimes they need to adjust something into the application level. As you see, it's not easy things. What type of team needs to support this type of operation? We need an agile team, and everybody needs to understand this is a kind of product, it's kind of service, and everybody needs to understand the common target is a stable product, workable product. It means this is a smaller groups, so we have those working in a big groups behind that. If somebody asking what type of business is from another perspective, this is a B2B2C. B2B between the HBO and the provider, and B2C between the provider and the customer. But behind that, we somehow support it. What means we have no direct relationship with the customer, so the customer need to communicate with the operators, operator communicate with the HBO, and HBO communicate with the developers. So this is a chain, and this is why it is important, the proactive support, because it takes time, sometimes takes days to find a solution. And of course, the operation. It's a service, 24/7. It's a lot of things happening in the background. Network problem, new device release of one of the Android providers, is lip sync problems, no subtitle displaying on this device for some reason. The player is get a black screen. Why? Because the new chipset not supported well. These all type of things need to understand the whole thing and need to communicate continuously. This was the theory, and let's see what's happened after we implemented.
So thank you, Peter. If you have some technical questions, we just reserve some time to the, at the end of the presentation. So that was the technical thinking about HBO GO. But what I would like to, or we would like to highlight here, technology is important to deliver a successful project in this TV everywhere world. But as HBO GO, as other development like HBO GO, is a fine combination of the technology, the business, some art, and some science. So in the third part of the presentation, we really would like to focus to the challenges, not just from technical point of view, but much more from organizational point of view, and just highlight who really can do it, or what are the challenges what you need to manage if you want to develop a premium pay TV application or service like HBO GO. First of all, HBO GO is a radical innovation. Radical innovation just required to pick up new competencies what you never used before. But what is more important and more difficult for an organization, even for a broadcast organization like us, who is good in the incremental innovation, but not that good in the radical one, sometimes you need to drop some new, or sometimes you need to drop the old practices. So something which is pretty well works in the broadcast world, it will not work in this new media world, as we call it. So one side of the story, you need to learn a lot of things, like conferences is a good option to pick up the new competencies, but you should be able to forget things also. There is no real best practice outside. So there are small building blocks. You can have some expert who can tell you what is the best container format, what is the best encoding format. But when you start to put the best practices together, you will not get the full picture at the end. So you just need to be ready. There is no best practice. The scope is a moving target. So something which is a really important function today maybe is not that important yesterday, and something, a new device support which was in the business plans just planned for a year, the business guys just knocking on your door and say, hey, we just need it earlier, can you help us, can you deliver it for us, and this just make your life really complicated. Because it's a web, everybody is an expert. So everybody can give you advice, everybody can tell you what to do, what not to do, how to do, what is important. But remember the Henry Ford quote. So they may have give you some input, but they really want a faster horse usually. So you need to be very careful with the advice and the materials and best practice guides what you find on the internet and what the guys for HBO try to tell to you. So you need always have a question mark in your mind. And you always need to see how can the whole stuff fit your overall picture, because it's really important. You need to make decisions without proper information. That's really difficult. So if you want to find the best codec, you can spend hours, days, months, years to find the best one. Technology is changing. So if you want to find the best and you want to collect enough information to make the best decision, as usually we do in the broadcast business, we just create big RFPs, RFPs, we just send it to vendors, create big workshops and try to find the holy grail of the solution. You should forget it in this radical innovation. You should be able to make decisions quickly without proper information. That's really difficult. What makes it more difficult? You need to do decisions without proper information, but really hard to undo. So that's the real headache. If you make a decision, what you can change quickly tomorrow, like write a code or just create a new UI function, say, oh, I don't like it, I want to change it, it's a few days for a developer to change for you. If you make a decision about video formats, DRM, server type, CDN strategy, you cannot undo these decisions. So it's really difficult. But you need to be ready to make decisions without proper information and make decisions really hard to undo. What was a painful lesson for us as a broadcaster, and maybe who just tried to create a high-level business case about the streaming service, is the demand-based costing. So for us as a broadcaster, the satellite bandwidth is a fixed fee. We don't need to care how many subscribers we have. The satellite distribution costing the same. If you just create a business case for a HBO GO-like distribution, the first question, okay, what is your CDN cost? Okay, how many subscribers I have or will have? What is the content consumption habit? What is the device penetration? What is the typical battery bandwidth in the country? So you need to do a lot of estimations without proper information, and based on that you need to create a business case. And the CDN guys, for example, they just don't really understand sometimes why this demand-based costing is a nightmare for a broadcaster. So that's why also partnership is really important. You just need to tell them, okay, I know your business models work pretty well if we talk about website acceleration and with other partners who already has experience with the demand-based costing, but help us to make a different business case, a different solution, because we don't feel comfortable us in this situation. And if you have real partners, not just guys who want to sell something to you, they will understand your need and they will help you to figure out what to do and how to do. So that's also important. The continuous delivery is a nightmare for everybody. It's necessary if you want to do a radical innovation, but it's really complicated. It's complicated from operation point of view, from deployment point of view, but it's also complicated for the full organization. Creative team, marketing team sometimes need more time to create a nice presentation or some nice flyer about a new function and manage the communication than the developer guys need to figure out and develop and deliver the whole function. So sometimes you need to urge the rest of the organization, and sometimes you need to be able to say no to the developers. Guys, I know this is a new function, we like it, but we need some time to deploy it and introduce it on the market. So that's also a nice challenge from organization point of view. The organization fit is also, that was a really painful lesson for us. We just simply was too agile for the rest of the company. So when we start this whole HBO GO, we just tried to do it in the very beginning as a broadcaster. We just developed the first version of, as we called, HBO GO 1.0, but it simply was not premium enough for HBO. We just developed it very slowly. The functionality, the flexibility, the multi-language support, and all the stuff was not good enough. And we just sit down and discuss what to do and how to do, and we just realize, okay, we can do it in a different way. We just started, and we just realize the rest of the company cannot support us, cannot follow us. And we was there and say, okay, what to do? We need to deliver a product. We have our mission, but the company is just not able to support us. Sometimes there was a lot of, let's say, fighting around HBO GO, and okay, we just remembered and tried to remember everybody for the reason and the vision, but it was hard. So what we do? Finally, we just find a way to manage the broadcast world and the more agile HBO GO development world together. And there is a small video which just show you what we really figure out, actually what we really just used is outside on the as a methodology. Thank you. So that's how we did it. Okay, I lost 10 euros because we make a bet. I say, okay, this is the country of Benny Hill, so this kind of video will work and everybody will love. And so I have to say it's not really. Let's see. So this is we believe this is a funny video. You may not like it, we like it. But it's just focused to a very interesting concept of the product development. And that's, as it called, skunkworks. The skunkworks used by the Lockheed end of the Second World War just to develop the Ford jet fighter is an isolated group of engineers and other guys who is separated from the rest of the company, connected to the company on a very non-bureaucratic way, and just really used the high level of autonomy to develop a new product. So that's what we did. We just create a skunkwork, we just create a company, we just put the developer guys separate from the rest of the organization. We just have a few guys as a gatekeeper who has the common knowledge from the broadcast business and also from the new media business, and we just do the development inside of this skunkwork. And time to time just release the new versions and just involve the necessary part of the company in a very structured way. So if you want to do a product which is a radical innovation for your organization, you may cannot change the whole organization in the same time. So this skunkwork concept, which is well documented on the internet, you really can use it to deliver something new. Later on, you need to figure out how to put all the stuff what developed by the skunkwork to the normal daily operation. But to develop something radically new, it's a really good framework. It gives us the necessary freedom, but also we can use the solid background provided by HBO. So that's what we did, that's how we did it. You may don't need to create a video like this, or even if you create, just show it inside of your organization, not on a conference. That's maybe the lesson I learned today, okay? So there is a small checklist, and if you bring one slide with you from this presentation, maybe this slide is the right one. So if you want to do a development like HBO GO, first of all, you need to understand your business. You need to know what you do is just support your current business model, what do you want to do, what do you want to do with your business model. Your business provides a lot of limitations, no questions, licensor limitations, requirements, legal requirements, when we need to add the new function, we just need to check with the legal guys, okay, it's okay from legal point of view, we just need to check with the programming guys, okay, can we do it from content point of view. So it's a lot of limitations, but also if you understand your business, it provides you a lot of possibilities, a lot of new options. As we developed our private CDN together with our affiliate partners just to deploy or streaming servers directly to their data center just close to their last mile. And as we just add the function to our system, and this system is just able to use the dedicated server only for the visitors who came from the given AS number or given IP range, is a big possibility provided by our business model. You just need to have a reason, and you just need to understand your reason. And also, the reason is not enough, you need a vision. As every project manager usually learn during their career, one of the most important part for a project is a powerful sponsor. So without a real sponsorship, it could be a small committee, it could be your CEO, it could be anybody who has a real power to support you, can help you to make the decision and can protect you if the decision is not really what the rest of the company like or understand. You need champions in your development. Champions is an essential part of the skunkwork methodology also. These guys are who maintain the why. So sometimes when you do the development, you just lost your trust and your vision. And these guys, champions, like the guy with the big mustache, unfortunately he's not able to hear today because on Friday he has some little operation and the doctor said he cannot fly. You need a champion who just refresh your team and can also work as a gatekeeper and can sell and tell the vision inside and outside of your organization. You need strategic partners. As Peter mentioned, you need strategic partners at the beginning of the delivery chain who help us to deliver your product. And you also need strategic partners who just help you to manage your business model. You need a plan to build organization synergy. So even if you use a skunk work, you need a plan how to put the things together at the end of the day. And what is also really important, you need a mind and the attitude which is free from risk aversion and loss aversion. As I just, or we just realized in our broadcast industry, this risk aversion and loss aversion is really strong. So we don't want to implement new things nobody used before, and we're not really happy to drop things what we used before just because we just want to do some more risky one. So risk aversion and loss aversion is a generic enemy of our happiness in our private lives, but also really important inside of an organization. So that's the checklist, and here is just some result about our work. I just need to speed up because it's time is over. So currently our HBO GO platform is available on two continents. Obviously it's available in Europe and also available in Asia. HBO Asia chose our platform to provide the multi-language service in Hong Kong, and later this year we will expand it to other countries in Asia. Currently we support 15 countries altogether. We have support 12 languages. Just a small information, we just introduced HBO GO in Bulgaria at the beginning of April, and we just need only 3 days to localize the user interface for all the devices to Cyrillic letters and using the Bulgarian language. So that's why it's important to create a flexible background system and the modular system, as Peter mentioned. Because if you need to spend too much time, too much resources to localize your service, for example, it just costs a lot of money and time. We have already integrated our HBO GO platform with more than 50 affiliate partners. Sometimes it's a complicated process, sometimes it's a very smooth one. And we continue to integrate the affiliate store system and make HBO GO available for more and more subscribers. We have a private CDN, it has more than 100 servers in Europe. Some of these servers sitting in neutral data centers and has some peering or transit connection to the public internet. Most of the servers sitting in data centers and connection points, POPs, of our affiliate partners and provide the streaming service today IP network today subscribers. This is a very powerful tool to manage your demand-based cost on a pretty low level. If your business model just allow you and your scale and demand just require to have and build a private CDN, you need to do it. That's a really cost-effective way. It's required some capex investment at the beginning, but if you just make some high-level calculation, it will turn back on the opex side very quickly. What is really important for us is a time to market. In case of Bulgaria, we was able to launch Bulgaria from the final business decision to the launch within 2 months. We just need these 2 months just to deploy your servers in Sofia, just secure the necessary internet connections and deploy your servers in the data center of the first operator partners. And typically the affiliate integration, which covers the streaming and the authentication that Peter mentioned, the typical time frame is 3 to 6 weeks. So I think it's pretty good. Our system already an award-winning platform. Last year, we just won the best content on-demand solution award at IBC from CSI magazine. But what is really important for us, and that's my last video before the questions, the feedback and the information what we receive from our users. So there is a small video about the user feedbacks here.
Hey man.
Dude, von Dudenstein, what are you doing tonight?
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself
Watch HBO, tell me. It's not TV, it's HBO.
Fourth time you've gone to the bathroom today. Let me see.
No, I'm not gonna let you see.
You're not gonna let me see because you're not taking a poop.
I've been flushing as I go.
You're flushing as you go.
Don't wanna stop at all.
Okay, I don't know, do you have some questions? If you have later, you can mail it to the answers at hbogo.eu and we are happy to answer it. Thanks for your time.